Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, respected brothers and sisters. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, wal aqibatu lil muttaqeen, wa salatu wa salamu ala Sayyidil Mursaleen, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'een. Allahumma lakal hamdu hamdan hamda, wa lakal shukru shukran shukra, a'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. وإذا سألك عبادي عني فإني قريب أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعان فليستجيبوا لي وليؤمنوا بي لعلهم يرشدون. We begin in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We bear witness that there is none worthy of worship except Allah. We bear witness that our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the last and final messenger. As we once again gather on this blessed day of Ramadan, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue showering His blessings upon us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue showering us with His rahmah and with His mercy. Truly, my dear brothers and sisters, we're going through blessed moments. This month of Ramadan is often a month that we connect with fasting. It's often a month that we connect with Salatul Taraweeh. And it's often a month that we connect with the Holy Qur'an. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Baqarah, He reminds us, after He mentions the verses of fasting, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the verses of the Qur'an, شَهْرُ رَمَضَانَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ فِيهِ الْقُرْآنِ. And then after this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us of a great act of ibadah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us of the act of making dua, turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us in the Holy Quran, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu dhkurullaha dhikran kathira. O you who believe, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dhikran kathira, not a small amount, but a great amount. It's imperative that we call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We remind ourselves of our Creator. We remind ourselves of how weak we are and how we as individuals are constantly in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our Lord, our Creator, our Sustainer subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are so many things that we can talk about when it comes to the act of ibadah in terms of making dua, in terms of turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now we're constantly reminded, the ulama have reminded us, that the act of making a dua is a superior act of ibadah. Many a time when we make dua, when we turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we don't really think of making dua as an act of ibadah. You know, it's not like as if I'm fasting or I'm you know, giving some charity or I'm standing up and offering salah. You know, because we as individuals, we consider dua to be a selfish act, like something for us. I'm asking something for myself. You know, it's something that's going to benefit me. So how can it be benefiting me? But subhanAllah, we're reminded that to make dua is a superior act of ibadah because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us to make dua. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Holy Quran is commanding us that make dua, call upon me. Ud'uni astajib lakum, call me, I will answer your call. So subhanallah, by calling upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are fulfilling a command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is an act of ibadah. Now, when a servant turns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when a servant turns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's a sign of servitude. It's a sign of submitting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We submit all of our affairs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We acknowledge that, Ya Allah, we have no power. Ya Allah, I'm not capable of doing anything. Ya Allah, you are capable. Ya Allah, we submit to you. Ya Allah, we bow down to you. Ya Allah, we beseech you. Ya Allah, we ask you for assistance. Ya Allah, we turn to you. When a servant is making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's a conversation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When a human being enjoys the company of another human being, then subhanAllah, we can sit with that person and we talk, and we can talk for hours on end. You know, subhanAllah, you're sitting with your friends and you're talking for a great amount of time. You're talking to your parents, you're talking to your sibling, and subhanAllah, you're there on the phone 30 minutes, 40 minutes, you lose track of time. You're talking to your children, and subhanAllah, you're talking to a small child, a baby, and subhanAllah, you know, that baby's talking nonsense, but subhanAllah, you continue. Why? Because you enjoy the company of that individual. You enjoy conversing with that individual. SubhanAllah, similarly, we should enjoy conversing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, many times people ask that, well, you know, when I make dua, you know, I run out of making dua, or I run out of things to say. And subhanAllah, which is quite surprising, because can we ever run out of things that we require? I'm not even talking about things to be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm going back to that, you know, human element of selfish, being selfish, asking for ourselves. Can we ever run out of things to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So subhanAllah, when we're making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are conversing with our beloved. It's a whispering conversation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ud'u rabbakum tadarru'an wa khufya. You know, call upon your Lord in humbleness. Quiet conversation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So subhanAllah, we remind ourselves that we need to constantly be calling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're reminded over and over again, you know, when it comes to the act of making dua, the act of calling upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's indeed a great act of ibadah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But subhanAllah, more specifically in the month of Ramadan, we're blessed with the time of iftar. These last few moments before the time of iftar, these are moments that we should be turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because these are times, numerous narrations, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reminds us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiving people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiving people in multitudes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiving and forgiving and forgiving. We just need to ensure that we're on that list. We just need to ensure that we're calling upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and making dua. Allahumma ij'alna min utaqai Ramadan. O Allah, make us amongst those who are forgiven in this blessed month of Ramadan. Make us amongst those who are forgiven, whom you forgive, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, make us amongst those people that are forgiven at the time of iftar. You know, these last few moments before the time of iftar, we should be putting everything aside, ensuring that all of our preparations are done, and we can sit down and make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Insha'Allah, in the next episode, we'll continue with the etiquette of making dua, with the adab of making dua. But subhanAllah, each week we want to try to cover a few specific du'as. And the du'a that I've chosen for this week is the du'a of Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam, a great prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A great prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us of Surah Yunus in numerous places in the Holy Quran. You know, in Surah As-Safat, in Surah Al-Anbiya, in Surah Yunus. And there are a few lessons that we learn from the life of Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam. But subhanAllah, it's a story which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Holy Quran. Prophet Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam was sent down, you know, to the people of Nineveh. It's a small town in the area of Mosul in present-day Iraq. And subhanAllah, you know, Prophet Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam is a biblical prophet. He's known as Jonah. And we all hear the story of Jonah or Yunus in, you know, in the stomach of the whale or the large fish type animal. But subhanAllah, he called upon his people. And he called his people to the message of Tawheed. And he called his people to the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he kept calling them and he kept calling them, just as we've seen with all of the Anbiya alayhim salatu wasalam. But subhanAllah, they kept rejecting his message. And they persisted in their disbelief. And they persisted in their wrongdoing. You know, Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam, at the end of the day, he was a human being. He was disappointed. He was frustrated. And Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam, he left his people. He left his nation. And he left them, cautioning them with the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. telling that a punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will arrive within a matter of days. Now, subhanallah. And subhanallah, he left his people. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us in the Holy Quran, فَلَوْلَا كَانَتْ قَرْيَةٌ آمَنَتْ فَنَفَعَهَا إِيمَانُهَا إِلَّا قَوْمَ يُونُسْ لَمَّا آمَنُوا كَشَفْنَا عَنْهُمْ عَذَابَ الْخِزِّي فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَمَتَّعْنَاهُمْ إِلَى حِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that was there any town that believed after seeing the punishment and its faith saved it except the people of Yunus? Because we know that when the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala arrives, it's too late. It's too late. Fir'aun called upon his Lord, but it was too late. The punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was before him. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, except the people of Yunus alayhi salatu wa salam. When Yunus alayhi salatu wa salam left, subhanallah, his people realized that subhanallah, a punishment of Allah is upon us. So they turned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Ibn Kathir subhanallah, he writes that they repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The men folk, the women folk, the children folk, the animals were bellowing. The animals were crying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And subhanallah, you know, this is the story of Yunus alayhi salatu wa salam. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us, وَذَنُّونِ إِذْ ذَهَبَ مُغَاضِبًا. You know, in Surah Yunus. And remember when Dhunnun, Prophet Yunus alayhi salatu wa salam, when he went off in anger, frustrated from the actions of his people. فَظَنَّ أَلَّا نَقَدِرْ عَلَيْهِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and he imagined that we wouldn't caution him. So subhanallah, Prophet Yunus alayhi salatu wa salam, he left his people, he went to the shores. And you know, the famous story, he boarded a ship. You know, he was upon a ship. And he was on this ship and they were in the ocean and a storm caught the ship and caught the journey. And subhanallah, the people started thinking that they would drown. So in desperation, as the ship was being pounded by waves on both sides, they decided that we need to decrease the weight and we need to throw someone aboard as a form of sacrifice. Because these were, you know, the methods of the people of those times. So subhanallah, they thought, you know, who should we throw aboard? So they decided to draw lots to see whose name would come out. And they drew lots. And the first time Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam's name came, and Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam, he was known by the people. The people knew that this was a pious individual. The people knew that this was a God-fearing individual. The people knew that this was an honest individual. This was a trustworthy individual. Subhanallah. So they said, we can't throw Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam out. You know, they drew lots a second time. Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam's name came. They drew lots a third time. Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam came. You know, subhanallah, the people of the boat, the people of the ship that he was on, they didn't want to throw him out. They didn't want to throw him out. But Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam, being the just Nabi that he was, he took his clothes off. And subhanallah, he decided, he jumped into the sea. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَسَاهَمَ فَكَانَ مِنَ الْمُضْحَضِينَ. That they drew, they cast lots, and he was amongst the losers. But subhanallah, you know, Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, the narration says that when he jumped into the sea, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded a large fish, similar to a whale or some other animal of that nature, to come and save Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam. So subhanallah, this fish comes and swallows Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he commanded the fish not to devour the flesh or not to break the bones of Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam. You know, as we see in the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam, قُلْنَا يَا نَارُ كُرْنِي بَرْدًا وَسَلَامًا عَلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمَ. The fire became a place of peace and coolness for Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. And we know, you know, the stomach has acidic liquids which help digest the food which is consumed, very strong. But subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded this fish, and subhanallah, the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was fulfilled. And you know, Ibn Kathir mentions that this fish, it went down to the bottom of the ocean. And at that point, Yunus alayhi salatu wa salam could hear the creations at the bottom of the ocean, the stones and the rocks, doing tasbih of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And subhanallah, Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam, he realized his mistake, that he shouldn't have left his people. He should have waited for, you know, the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he called upon his Lord, فَنَادَى فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ, and he called, he cried through the depths of the darkness, saying, لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ, there is no God but you. Subhanak, glorified be you. إِنِّي كُنْتُ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ, I have been of the wrongdoers. This is the verse of Surah Al-Anbiya, the 21st chapter of the Holy Quran, verse number 87. Subhanallah, he cried out, فَنَادَى فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ, not one darkness, multiple darknesses. And the Mufassirun have written, that what are the darknesses? The first darkness is the belly of the fish. There's no electricity, there's no lights, there's no mobile phone to hold. He was in the darkness of the fish. Number two, the darkness of the ocean. If we've seen documentaries, we know that subhanallah, when you go deep into the ocean, you know, beyond a certain level, there is no light. There is no light. Pitch dark. The darkness of the ocean. And number three, the darkness of the night. All three darknesses gathered. And in this, he called upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He called upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, La ilaha illa ant, subhanak, inni kuntu min al-zalimeen. And subhanallah, we know what happened. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the fish to then take Yunus alayhi salatu wa salam after some point in time. We don't know how long, but and Yunus alayhi salatu wa salam was left in a desert. The fish basically took Yunus alayhi salatu wa salam out. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْغَمِّ, and we answered his call and we delivered him from the distress that he was in. وَكَذَلِكَ نُنْجِي الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, and this is what we do. This is how we save. This is what we save. You know, this is how we save the believers. لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ سُبْحَانَكَ إِنِّي كُنْتُ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. And the reason why I chose this dua today is because we are going through difficult times. And we have been reminded over and over again to recite this dua. As we've been going through these difficult times over the last few weeks, we've been reminded to recite this dua. Why is it that we've been reminded to recite this dua? Now, subhanallah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reminds us that no Muslim ever prays to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَإِنَّهُ لَمْ يَدْعُ بِهَا مُسْلِمٌ رَبَّهُ فِي شَيْءٍ قَطْ إِلَّا اسْتَجَابَ لَهُ, except that Allah will answer his prayers. The Prophet ﷺ is saying that there is no believer, meaning when a believer uses these words, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will definitely answer his prayers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَكَذَلِكَ نُنْجِي الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, this is how we save the believers. This is how we save the believers. You know, subhanallah, this is an amazing, amazing dua that we have been taught by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have been taught by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the dua of Yunus alayhi salatu wa salam. No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he reminds us that we call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect us and safeguard us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Yunus alayhi salatu wa salam from the moment of distress that he was in. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reminds us that if we call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala using these same words, he will protect us and he will save us inshaAllah. You know, Yunus alayhi salatu wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us, فَلَوْلَا أَنَّهُ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُسَبِّحِينَ لَلَبِثَ فِي بَطْنِهِ إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ, had it not been of them, had he not been of them who glorified Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then he would have remained inside the belly of the fish till the day of resurrection. Now, from this story, we're reminded to be mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The story of Yunus alayhi salatu wa salam, in this dua of Yunus alayhi salatu wa salam, it teaches us, number one, that we should be patient in our affairs. No matter what happens, be patient. إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there with us. Number two, we're taught that we should acknowledge our mistakes, acknowledge our weaknesses. When we go through the method of making dua, we learn that we don't just say, Ya Allah, grant me this, grant me, you know, the method of making tawbah, The first thing is we acknowledge, Ya Allah, I committed this sin. Ya Allah, I did this wrong. Ya Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes it when we acknowledge our wrongs, because it takes a lot for a human being to acknowledge their wrong. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, yes, maybe you're shy of, you know, acknowledging your wrongs in front of other people, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Rabbul Alameen. He knows everything. There's no hiding from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, in Ramadan, when we're fasting, we're trying to acquire taqwa, to be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What can we hide from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? There is nothing we can hide from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing that we can hide from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Acknowledge our shortcomings. Yunus alayhi salatu wa salam, he said, I was among the wrongdoers. Inni kuntu min al-zalimeen. Let us acknowledge our wrongs. And number three, let us repent for our mistakes. Let us repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the wrong that we have done. And number four, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us, if Yunus alayhi salatu wa salam, if he didn't constantly praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he would have been in that hardship. We need to constantly praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can forgive us our shortcomings. You know, we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us our shortcomings. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us during this month of Ramadan, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow this month of Ramadan to depart in a state that we are forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These last few moments that we have, inshallah, let us collectively as a family, let us as individuals turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and make dua, inshallah. Please don't waste these last few moments before the time of Maghrib. Constantly turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us in khair. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to benefit from the words of the Quran, from the teachings of our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And inshallah, we will continue with the topic of dua in our next session. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.